Rollup Helper is meant to be easy to set up and use, but in this series of videos, I'll review the steps to troubleshoot your rollups and how to fix common issues. Each of these steps will be covered more in depth in separate videos, but here is the order to check issues. If you're waiting for a rollup to process, but the target field is staying null, check the queue. Make sure queue items are completed and are not stuck or backed up. If queue items are stuck, check Apex Jobs. If queue items are completed but the target field didn't update, check Rollup Helper exceptions, including record locks and filter field validation. If the rollup appears to be running successfully but the target field still does not have the expected result, use the rollup preview to ensure filters are configured to return the expected result. After all of that is completed, look into issues of rollups not running in real time if needed. This video is going to go over step 1B, what to do if you're encountering the unable to lock row error. If you need instructions on any of these other steps, please check out the other videos in this playlist. What to do if you're encountering the unable to lock row error. The error unable to lock row, unable to obtain exclusive access to this record is usually caused by one of three things. A user editing a record that is being edited by an asynchronous Rollup Helper job. Rollup Helper asynchronous jobs attempting to lock the same record, or multiple jobs trying to modify the validation helper setting. Due to the nature of record lock errors and the lack of debugging information provided by Salesforce, it is often not possible to reproduce or track the exact source of a specific record lock occurrence or to stop record locks from happening entirely. Because of this, our developers created a schedule job that will retry any rollups that were not able to update because of a record lock. This job is scheduled from the Apex Jobs page. When it is active, it will retry any records that were blocked by that exception at 11 p.m. every night by default. After the job completes, you will see the exception message logged in your org. But as long as no new exceptions were logged at 11 p.m., then the retry job was successful. If it was not successful, it will update the record again the next time the job runs. Here are some best practices to avoid record locks. Check for overlapping schedules. Two schedules updating the same object should not start at the same time if possible. Check for queue buildup. Having records in the queue or objects processing asynchronously can lead to record locks. Reduce asynchronous processing. This can be done by removing force asynchronous flags on triggers and increasing the usage percentage of limits in custom settings. Avoid running rollups back to back. Wait around 5 minutes to allow for a few batches to complete before starting another rollup that updates the same target object. Running rollups during business hours when users are also interacting with records or during a time when another process is doing batch updates to the same object can lead to record locks. If shared activities is turned on, all task and event rollups will have to update asynchronously. This feature can be found under Activity Settings from Setup in Salesforce, allow users to relate multiple contacts to tasks and events. Single parent process can help record locks coming from the queue, but you need to be careful because it can also slow down the queue, leading towards a buildup and more record locks. If you still need help or have other issues, there are many ways to find answers. For self-service, we have the Rollup Helper admin guide, both in app and on our website. And we also have a knowledge base where you can search for your issue. If you want to get in touch with our support team, you can email us at support@passagetech.com. You can start a live chat on our website, or you can sign up for a one-on-one session to ask questions.